Guys, this is another quick personal security tip. One thing I want to talk about with the EDC knife, or any weapon or tool for that matter, if you are carrying it, I highly, highly suggest or recommend that you don't post about it, you don't talk about it, keep people on a need-to-know basis. I see a lot of people who we consider knife collectors rather than those who actually live by it, or you know, they would rather talk about it than be about it, is what I'm trying to say. If you do carry, you know, you don't need to talk about it, you don't need to tell the world, and you don't need to put it up on Facebook and fucking Instagram and whatever, because if you are involved in an incident, you know, whether you've got privacy, security settings, whatever on your Facebook and other social media platforms, they can be cracked by law enforcement and they can be checked. So things can be, in the eyes of the law, seem to be premeditated if you're out there saying like, oh, yeah, I do this and I do that and blah, blah, blah. A lot of things are against you. A lot of laws are criminal friendly. A lot of states have become criminal friendly. So even though your intention may be to protect yourself, it first starts with InfoSec, okay? So information security before OPSEC, operational security. If you don't have InfoSec, you don't have OPSEC, okay? So that's how it is in the professional world. So that's a quick tip for you. If you haven't already, check out our online learning. There's plenty more there. It's a free week trial. And also check out your Yojimbo fight gear for the coolest dojo swag out. Cheers.
Situation. Considering that stress, you're not going to remember shit. You lose your dexterity. You lose the control of your fine motor skills. You're not going to be able to do any of that, okay? And he, as in the threat, sure as fuck isn't going to stand there and let you do any of it either.